Alright, so, oh my goodness, back to it, explaining of, I've been here working on this retirement stipend banking spreadsheet, and it has more added to it now. I am Each month you can actually put in. Not each month, don't say that much, no. It's only a yearly stipend plan. Each year, you can actually select and choose your preferred amount. So if you want 700, or if you want 300, or if you want 200, you can switch those, and so that's a great thing. And so I updated it to offer this. Otherwise it was, I don't know, it's kind of, it was only a certain m number. Certain made the reduction method of starts with a much higher number, and then it reduces to like a small number, like 50 a month or something, and then or the other one that was fixed, a fixed amount off of 50,000. It was like only like, I don't know, 198 or 178 every month. So it's, you have those two versions. I know it's confusing, but yeah, it's just something that is part of it. So, oh my goodness. And so I've made mistakes, I've made many errors, I know it. But it's still working, it's still working. But I believe I've taken out all of the anything that has the fault, or the divs, or the value errors. All of those are gone. Hopefully, unless I created something new just now today. But no, I believe those are all removed. So it's now it's just mathematical, and the appealance of which is the best math to look at, easily to use. And it's only the yellow boxes. You only fill in the yellow boxes. So it's a pretty simple system. Just you, if you have the one bank account, there's two versions: the reduction method, or you can go with the starting of the fixed method. But of all of them, let you choose now which number. So it's amazing, and then also along all of. And then there's a two bank account version. So, but I'm not trying to sell it yet, because or sell it at all, actually, because I'm still working on it. So that's where I've been, but it's still capturable. You can take it and look at it, but it is not locked. I have not locked it any of the formula areas, so it is possible that you can delete it quickly. What the hell was I saying? I was talking of, oh my gosh, as I go on further, so just take it with a grain of salt at this point. I can't, I have to stop. I have to stop myself, and from getting too aggressive with it being finished, because there are possibilities of it not being. I have to go back and double test it. So I am there quite often doing this. So in my upgrades of thoughts, what was it about? I was trying to say we needed to change the world a little bit, and offer the stone ground mills instead of any of the metal ones, just for our brain power. I believe that's been part of our problem with our health, is we're having a lot of our flours and our corns, and I know I am awfully close, huh? Sorry, I didn't mean to do this, but a lot of flours and corns. We are just ground with the metals, so I'm thinking if we can go to stone grinders, that would help the brain power of the person's earth. Is this earth? Oh my gosh! I wanted to tell also, much more exciting was I have seen it in it's a bright, it's very bright, and it's a star of some sort, and it is. It's very close, very close, and I see it in the morning, and it is brighter and bigger than any planet I've ever known. It is practically as big as a moon, as the moon is, but with a shine, with brightness. So what is it? What is it? Wow, it is something tremendous, isn't it? It's something absolutely tremendous. And it is new, and I've never seen this before in our solar system. So how did it happen? How did it happen? And I started thinking in a strange, is this the Nibiru? Is it finally here? And this is bright bunny in the sky out there. It's massive. It's a massive thing. And in the morning, it is there, and it's in the southern eastern sky, more looking in the southeastern sky. So I have to check to see if I have audio on this, because oftentimes I set this thing up without even the sound. What else? Oh my gosh. Well, anyway, that's all. That's all I've been up to. That's where I've been, and gardening some. I've also been gardening, and yeah, everything is. What can you say about the garden? Everything is going all right. It's a little early. It's a little early, isn't it? So yeah, so it's the impatient time now. It's like, because it has the bloom of a few days of really, really intensified days of sunshine, but I'm not thinking it's enough yet. It's still cold in the evenings. So my goodness, yeah. So go ahead with this siphonware thing, but oh my gosh. So yeah, I'm just consumed in it at the moment. Yeah, it's like a once I begin on these, I can't seem to get out of them. They're like, you can say a bad habit, or something that's obsessive that I have to get into, but it's just to finish it to completion. It is actually, I can claim the thing that it's complete, that it is done. I can say that. I can definitely say it's finished, but it's not necessarily, what do you call it, really beta checked, double checked and double checked again. So I have to, and doing that means I have to run numbers through, run more and more numbers through, just in case I got some reversals. I may have a couple of reversals, with the formulas. With the negatives, when you're going into the negatives of the mathematics, they can get tricky. So there's some. Yeah, I don't know what this star is, but there's definitely something is affectant. My gosh, it's an affectant. Wow, anything that big, perhaps it is carrying some kind of transmission juice, extra. So I'm feeling completely wired. Completely wired, but yeah, I know. I said the sheet was done a couple of weeks ago or so, and then I'm yeah, I did, didn't I? I'm like on the 24th or something of March. See how the time goes? See how the time goes with this computerization? I just lost a few weeks of my high grade blogging here, blogging on the internet. Like, yeah, once that, it's all right, it's all right. I have to do something sometimes. So I hope it's helpful. I hope it's helpful to, I mean, it's very simple. You just fill in the yellow numbers. It should be pretty explanatory that way. Not the yellow numbers, the yellow boxes, and yeah, you just know if you want one bank account or two bank accounts, and if you have, and what's really really cool is if you have the two bank accounts, you can still have money go in and money go out. Oh, actually, you can have withdrawals from both, from the one bank account or the two. But if you pick the one bank account only version, it just doesn't have, most likely you're not going to have that high interest. And unless it is a super account. If you have one amazing account that gives you that high interest, you can keep it, and you can also use it for deposits and withdrawals also. So if you have one bank account that's a great account, then it works for you also. Oh, I added the maintainer fee section. So if you have the buy person who has the eyes and who has the access to the internet, and also the what else do they need? They need access to the internet. They need good eyesight. They also have to be I don't know, probably able to handle a spreadsheet. And so they handle your money essentially, and they, I guess they call them financial planners, or but not planners. No, they're financial actual assistants. Because they're not planning anything, they're actually there making sure you are receiving your stipend. So all of this is all there, and then, yeah, and this will all receive. So for the maintenance fee people, they just put in their percentage, and then it also gives a little percentage for me on the side also, as an idea, as a donation. And then so if you have a main if you have an incoming retirement always, like if it's 500 or 10,000, that shows up every month, it's there, and so all of this is accepted in, so you can have that also as input, so it has that strength to it. Yeah, so I guess the big deal is figuring out the maintainer fee. Like if you are a maintainer, let's say you just work accounts for just four or five old persons that that just can't handle it. They can't handle their bank accounts, but yet they need their money handled some way. And well, so it figures out the percentage. So if you want to take 5% of their sum total. It's the main total. So if they have 500 grand or whatever, you take 5% of that, and you get it divvied out over the time frame, each year, for 21 years. So that's, I don't know, that's the way I went. And then you can pick any percentage you want from that 500 grand or whatever. So that's. Yeah, I don't know. So what I think about that, this getting older, and then you, how do you access your internet to actually see your account, any longer, on this, like, who do you trust? Who do you trust? Who do you trust? Who's the person you're going to give them the access code keys, and you're going to actually have to give them your bank account with password also. So they have to have all of these things available to them. So it's like handing over, it's like handing over quite a bit to one person. So you're like, how, well, then we run to family, don't we? Say, well, I can trust maybe the family member not going to run away and steal it. And I'm like, well, that gets difficult because then there's frictions and persons get in fights, and so it's just like, well, how do you fix that? You have to have someone stable that is not going to be in a fictitious state, is not going to be in the fights, and that you can give this password to, and then if it is they're getting money for it. It doesn't necessarily, just because you give them money does not mean they're not going to run away with it. So if you go the maintainer fee route, it doesn't mean they're and you give them a password, it doesn't mean they're not going to take your money, possibly as a thief. So this is a strange problem, isn't it? Is how do we make sure? It's almost like the account needs to have a double identity system. Built in for the person who is the maintainer, the good eyes, and then versus the person who almost like these they need to have oh no, they're gonna need full access. So if they're taking full transfers in, well, maybe for transfers in it doesn't matter. Maybe only withdrawals. Maybe for major withdrawals, that would be the way to go. That would be the way to go. Is certain withdrawals would have to have a halt stop. You know, they just can't happen unless this person, this elderly person without very good eyesight or ability to use a machine, they would be, the elderly person would have to be called in if the withdrawal was too great, because the stipend itself is supposed to be small. You know, it's just supposed to be a small amount. It's not supposed to be, you know, all of it all at once, you know, month to month. I don't know. Yeah, it becomes an odd problem, doesn't it? Because now it's digital money there. It's digital money there, and I don't know. In a way, it's almost like, who do you trust? You know, who do you trust? Yeah, I know. It's like doing the back paddle in the water and going, oh, is there this person over there that was my friend once? And over there, maybe they are. And oh my goodness, I'm not sure. I'm not sure. After many of us have been propelled forward in the water, away from people, away from persons, I don't think we can back pedal to them any longer, you know. So it's almost like after bridge after bridge after bridge after bridge has, I don't like the term burned, but yeah, after it's like a tough revisit. You don't really want to go there. So it's like a lot of us are in the flounder state, like, oh my gosh, I completely forgot that I need the help. I will need the help on the machine to see it, to actually see the money, to make sure I have made the payments of its digital works, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, so in a way it's almost a time now where I can already see and envision unions of people joining. Not the old union of the past, but more of a cooperatives, where you'll have like secretaries or that are all part of one cooperative, and these secretaries will all get together, and they will have trusted persons, and they'll already have some kind of high fixed penalty if something happens against. So it's gonna get crazy, isn't it? A group for these people or a group for those persons. To safety protect them, their money, while it's being maintained, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, I don't know. The money system is... I don't want to talk about it anymore. It's there anyway. So that's where I've been. I've been there at that edit update place in the Google. I don't know. Sometimes I'm lost. I'm lost in my own eyes, you know. I'm just like, why do I have to do this? You know, why do I have to do this? I'm just, you know, numbers calculating here again and again. More numbers calculating, you know. Why do I have to be this upgrader? You know, this helper upgrader, because it is a helper, you know. And I'm like, well, why do I have to be some helper upgrader type person? Well, it's probably also, you can see this already, that persons at a bank, a normal bank out there, would be charged an atrocious fee to have it handled for them. And they'll probably use exactly similar software as I've just written. So it'll be very much so. It'll be like, well, so here it is free. So now am I the idiot that I just made this for those banks to go and charge a huge fee? Well, I guess I don't know. I don't know about that. But that's the way it goes. They're all this way, aren't they? Can you give me this? Can you give me that choice? I want this other choice. It's money numbers and money numbers and money numbers, you know. After all the years of working and making the numbers a certain savings certain savings amount, they're there in the desperation now to continue controlling it, you know, continue controlling it, even though what? Even though they can't see the screen, even though they cannot see the numbers on the yeah, they can't see any longer. It must be a strange place. And then, so after all of these, they can't backpedal anymore, you know, to persons that they used to be with or persons that they associated with. Yeah. So it's a loss of control at that point. It's a loss of control. So they've gone to this massive savings amount. And some of these people have huge savings now because of these house prices. It's just like anybody out there seems to have like the house market monopoly overload. And some really, really gross people in association with it also. Just really awful. Really awful. Really, really, I can't believe it. There were persons here at the house. They came around to they came around to the back of the house and they tried to break in, and were yelling and cussing at me in really, really gross tones and tonations, and I'm like, that is not even possible. I mean, are they like actors or actresses? And it is something British in there. There's something British, some British the way they were speaking, but they were so crude there that I don't know, something to do with this association with houses, something to do with they thought they had some up or something. So it seems like the higher these house prices had gone, maybe there's been a collapse. I haven't been watching the news. As high as they have gone, it's just invited everybody to the party, hasn't it? And everybody gross, you know, persons that are just like, I told them, say the scum low life of the planet, are just wealth now? The scum low life of the planet are wealth, you know? It's just like, oh my gosh. It's not supposed to be this way. When the scum lowlife of the planet have money, I don't know. At first, it's funny, you know, one or two. Well, it wasn't ever funny, actually. But when, at first, it's passable. One or two win a lottery. They win a lottery ticket or something, and they're like, "Oh, great! They got the 10 million or whatever." But now it's just like an entire what do you call them? Entire like generation of lowlifes are able to just throw gross amounts of money out there and do whatever they want with it. So I don't know what are we talking about. Time for the house prices to collapse. We're like, well, maybe they can't. Maybe the system broke. Maybe it was a math problem that they couldn't fix. I'm possibly believing so. Yeah, a math problem they couldn't fix, and so now we're all entering into impossible. That certain humans have acquired such gross wealth in a short while, a very short while, five years, 10 years. It's absolutely disgusting. Just because of the price of the house, you know. It's not fair. None of this house pricing is fair. Because, I mean, if they're here, I don't know, 300 years old or 400 years old, this house is, you know, and then they stamp a price on it now in this time frame. It doesn't seem right. It doesn't seem to be a possible correct. And it, when it wasn't built by them, it wasn't built by them. Just like this house just keeps getting resold and resold and resold, and it's at the bank's whimsy. So the bank is quite happy. The bank is quite happy. It's getting its whimsy events again and again and again every 20 years. Well, anyway, I don't know. I'm just over chattery. I just wanted to say it's okay. It's okay. It's workable. It's workable, and I believe I removed any of the atrocious errors. And but I'm still testing the sheet, and it works for anybody at any age. You don't have to be for the retirements. You can work at it when you're like, you know, 10 years old or 20 years old, and you have money and you want it to last a long time. And then and also if you cut the time frame shorter. It will tell you your account is closed, so it does things like this, and it tells you when's the next month, and it tells you where the next monthly stipend is, and so it is a pretty good one. It's a pretty good one. I'm pretty happy with it. However, like I said, I'm still verifying the numerations, so. But I'm getting tired, and I almost have reached a pinnacle point where I almost can't any longer. You know, I think I've gone too far. You know, it's not nothing about being fun any longer. It's absolute exhaustion. So, yeah. So anyway, I'll leave it at that, and not really know where I'm going any further with this system, this discussion. Yeah, I don't know. Money system, the money system, back to me and my New World Government there. We all have the 20,000 every year. We have our cute little gadget. You know, gets loaded in. With sand or with a fish, a new fish or a plant on the video display, and that's our new money. You know, is this you know fill up your little video, your video card action, and by the end when it's filled, when it's completely filled, you're out of it. You know, you've spent it all. So it's a different concept. So when you go to the store, you actually. They have like a little code thing or a little plug that they stick into to the device, and it trails it and it trails it and gives you you get a new fish or you get a rabbit, and in the scene, you know, so it's like a video scene, so it's a different type of money. It's a different type of money. It's a much funner type of money, and so. At the end, you know, maybe you have five or six rabbits maximum, but in the very beginning, maybe you only have one rabbit, and then further on, you've got the five or six rabbits, and then you have three stars available, and you've filled up your entire little video game there, and so yeah, so money can be much funner. So you spend to this 20, and then after. But the 20 is a limit, so you can never go over. You can never go over it. You always still have a monthly, a daily amount for food and housing. So there is a lock on it. There is a lock, so you can't spend it all at the beginning. So you have money all to the very last day, to the very last day. So it is a system that stops poverty from being an occurrence. Where if we all have it, you know, we all have it. And but it does not stop entrepreneurism either. It continues it. So I don't know. I just prefer it. This is it can be worked with this system also. This retirement thing can also It also, I know, seems like a dream cake candy I'm talking about, isn't it? I'm speaking of any kind of system other than the atrocious. It seems like, what? I don't know. I don't. It seems like, why not? Why isn't it already stated? Why go through the gruelings of having, million Ethiopians all of a sudden in some type of starvation situation with rice dumpage? Why is that going on? Why not just fix it? Why not just give everybody this digital money, and it keeps reoccurring, and the economy is still getting fat with all of the work, and all of the businesses are funded from these little cards. All the workers have to pay to. I know, it's an odd one. Yeah, the workers have to pay to work. And the workers have to pay to work, and that money supports the business. That money is the is what is the bank loan is the workers. So if you have 5 or 10 workers, they pay money into it to buy the product, and then with all of that, you have a backing every day from your from or as many days as they're working. I know it's not very many, but as many days as they're working. And so I don't know. It seemed like a better system for the planet. Less pollution. I don't know. Seems like I don't know, there's no difference. There's no difference really. It's just a change of how money is treated, rather than here it is, here's your money here in your hand. It would be, here's something on your car that's filled up, and you have a new plant or something. A new bit of sand in your little image viewer. So yeah. And then the person's work also, and if they're not working, because that's a big stress on everyone, they're not working. I actually don't know how to penalize the ones who really decide not to work. So that is the one deal. Perhaps they can't rent houses or not rent houses, but not buy house. Maybe they can't be the house purchaser or something. So maybe there is a way you could penalize them to not be the house purchaser, and that would stop them. But they would still be supporting the economy, though. They would still be paying. They would still be going to those stores. You see, they'd still be going to the stores. They would still be buying products. So they're not actually a glut or a glutton on anything, because they're still purchasing. As long as they have money in their pocket to purchase, the economy is rolling. The economy is moving. So, yeah. Anyway, and then with that, we'll have persons who have more time on their hands, also intelligence-wise, to think and not just be in a herd of human beings waiting for rice to be dumped on them from helicopters. Yeah, they have time to actually, use prophylactics and all of that,